Hi guys, it's Lottie here again for this week's instalment of my Stoma Diaries. One thing a number of people have been asking me about is what do you need? How does the stoma actually work? Where is it and so on? So I thought I'd run through what I have in my little magic boxes that I have to take care of the stoma. You may have seen a few different videos about how things work in the States, but in Ireland here, everything is actually provided for you to take care of yourself. All the gear I've got laid out behind me, which I'm going to run through in a moment for you, everything is brought to you by your stoma nurse who visits you in your home. And that was one of the amazing things to find out for me, that wonderful Madeline would actually be coming here. And for the first 3 weeks, 3-4 weeks, actually came nearly every other day to make sure that I knew exactly how to change my bag, exactly what I needed to do to help me through the tough times as well, which was actually really lovely that you feel you have that support network helping you through everything. There's also the team at the hospital that you can call up any questions anytime, and then they deliver bulk supplies for you, so you make sure you never reach a point where you're going to run out of anything, and therefore you're not out of pocket. So where is the bag? Well, every single person is slightly different, but for me, my bag, you can hardly even see, is under here. It's actually tucked in nicely into my underpants there. Everybody's is in a slightly different place, and I undo it at the bottom. I can show you the bag itself here has a little Velcro tag at the bottom here that literally you, sorry, that's the back of it there I was showing you, that literally you, when you fold it up, it, khaki fingers here, when you fold it up, it goes onto a little Velcro thing, and then the bag itself there fills up. Your stoma is sticking out of this hole here, which comes to you like that. That goes over where the stoma itself is. That's part of your small intestine that's actually sticking out. All of them are very different sizes, and I've had a few issues with mine because it was small, and so it was tricky because mine is actually facing downwards as well. It actually, like a little knuckle, it faces down onto the skin. So I've had all sorts of issues with burning of the stomach acids that are turned into alkaline by the time they actually reach your small intestine. So I've been told by my wonderful nutritionist Gay that the alkaline, so it's a bit like having caustic soda literally going straight onto your skin, and it burns like it's a good 2-inch hole that's been underneath, well, not a hole, but just goes straight onto the skin and burns the skin away. So I've been having to have all sorts of little extra bits and pieces, layers of fake skin that you can put on to help yourself with that and to try and help the healing around there. There's special powder that you can put on, and then my goo, you'll hear about that in a second, that the stoma, like, it's like a second layer of skin that goes on to your goes on around all this extra stuff before you put the bag on the top. So you can see online there's a few different videos from the States about how to change the bag. I might have the guts, you never know, might have the guts to do one of those for you. But I think just showing you the equipment that we have and that you will need to have to take care of yourself, it's actually very, very easy. I was surprised how easy it is to cope with using the stoma bag, getting used to it, all of that kind of thing. What you eat, what you can, what you can't eat, definitely know things that go in and come out the hole, basically things like mushrooms, sweet corn, whole nuts, just to be wary of, because the worst thing that can happen is a blockage as the small intestine comes out of your skin almost at a 90 degree angle. You want to make sure that that angle doesn't get blocked up with food, and I've been told apparently it's as bad as being in labour by some of the women who've had a blockage before. So that's the main thing that we're looking to avoid. I've been loving purees. I'm 6 weeks in now. The first 3 weeks, no fruit, no veg, because you don't want the fibre, you don't want everything too active. And I found with my bag for the first few weeks, any liquid that I drink, gurgle, there's a gurgle there. You know it's working when it's gurgling. Excuse me for that, if you heard that one? Yeah, any liquid that you drink, it's pretty quickly coming through you. And the main aim that the stoma care people ask you to watch out for is that you have a steady flow through there. You don't want things going through your digestive system too quickly. And if you drink too much fluid in one go, it literally just flushes out or any food that you have in you. So therefore your stomach and your small intestine have very little time to absorb any of the nutrients, and we're not getting the benefit from it. And I wonder if when I first started that was the reason I was feeling quite so tired, because I was the food was flowing and the liquid was flowing through me far too quickly. Got used to doing that a bit better now. I was being paranoid at the very beginning, because changing the bag, the worst thing that can happen is it just keeps on going and it keeps on going. And I've had the screaming moments, screaming off my head. My poor husband sitting there trying to keep my morale up, but screaming as you've just got everything ready. You've just put the fake skin on the bottom. You've just got the bag. You've put the goo everywhere. Just got everything ready. And then it all erupts again. And it's just like, oh, got to start all over again. So I had a couple of sessions like that. You do get used to it. So I tend to change mine first thing in the morning when I've finished eating by about 6:37 at night, so that during the night, everything has had a chance to be digested and come out of the other end. So I know when I wake up first thing in the morning, before I eat anything else or drink anything even, I'm changing the bag over. It's far less likely to be active. It is the times where I've had to change it later in the day because of the burns on my skin being so sore underneath, even with all these extra layers and protective layers, the sting is still going on there, that I've had to change it later in the day. So once you've eaten anything, just be aware. It's likely that your stoma will start producing effluent, for a polite way of putting it, waste product at the other end. So I like it first thing in the morning. Other people prefer doing it in the afternoon, in the evening, whatever suits you. You will get into your own routine. So let's have a quick look now at all the gear that you will need and that gets provided for you.